Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. Today I'm looking at a dividing head from Vivor. It's been many years since I've used a dividing head, so I thought we'd start from the beginning and go through what a dividing head does, how it works, and what we can use it for. So let's go to the workshop and see how we use it. The first thing I must say is this arrived the next day. This is the semi-universal dividing head. It's a model BS0. So let's have a look what's in the box. The weight of this with a 5-inch 3-jaw chuck is 27 kilos. So what do we get in the box? Chuck key, 3 chuck jaws, screws, just a collar that goes over the thread where the chuck fits, the handle, or part of the handle. This is a carrier. The screws are in here, and these are the keys that fit under the bottom of the dividing head and the tailstock. So underneath this I've taken the plastic bags off so you can see easier. Tailstock and the dividing head with the chuck fitted. On this side, two plates with the holes in, dividing plates. This is a number 2 Morse taper centre, and this is the handle for the dividing head. We also got the instruction manual, which goes into detail, some sizes and dimensions of the dividing head. What you get with it. And it does tell you how to use the indexing. And how to calculate the divisions. So I'll take these into the workshop and we'll have a look on the milling machine. So first of all, we'll take a look at the tailstock. It's quite a simple tailstock. Centre at this end, which is held in a hole. These clamps tighten the centre up. This is height adjustment, so you can set the height to suit your dividing head. Once you've set the height, you don't need to touch that again. And on this end, you have a knob which feeds in the centre. Underneath a slot, in that slot the keys fit, you see that one there. They've got screws for them, and the only problem I have on my machine is the slot in the table here. These are a bit big, so I'll need to mill a bit off the side so they fit in the slot. Well, that's good in a way, because I can make it an exact fit for my machine. And it has exactly the same keyway on the dividing head. Well, that's a tailstock. Here's the dividing head. So this is a clamp to stop it rotating. This lever operates a plunger here, so you can see it. Comes out and will fit into some of the holes around this indexing plate and the 3-jaw chuck. 5-inch 3-jaw chuck. I'll take the chuck off. The thread here is 1.5-inch by 1/8 pitch, and that is the same as the Boxford. So you can use your Boxford chucks, face plates, 4-jaw chuck on the dividing head. Now you can see the plate here, fit the handle. This part goes in and you just tighten the screw. This is spring loaded, so if you turn it the plunger will come out, and that plunger fits into the holes in this plate. You can see the holes in the plate. So around the outside you have a pointer here, at zero there, and it's marked in degrees up to 360 all the way around. This lever on the top operates this plunger. You can see there, now it's out, you can turn the head, bring the plunger in, and it locks it. And there are 24 positions there that you can choose from. So if you have something that you want to make that you can divide it into 24, you can use this. If not, you need the indexing plates on the side here. Look at the side. The handle, this is a spring-loaded plunger. You see it there. And that will locate in whichever hole that you need on the disc. You also have a set of arms that you can open and shut, and these are for counting the positions. I'll show you that later. Here you have your zero mark for the horizontal position, and this can rotate from minus 10 up to 90 degrees. If you put a faceplate on, it'll be about 7 inches off the bed of the milling machine. It's in there. And this is a number 2 Morse taper. Hold the bar in the chuck. So now I want to machine a hexagon on the end of this bar. We know this has 24 holes around this plate. So 24 divided by 6 is 4. We start off by machining the first flat. We've machined the first flat at zero. Now we need to index 4 holes to the second one. It's not 4 turns, it's 4 holes. And this is what makes this useful. You haven't got to keep changing your divider here to get the right hole. It's a direct 4 holes. Disconnect the lever. Withdraw the pin. Turn this round to the fourth hole. 1, 2, 3, that's there. Put the pin back in and then machine the next flat. Get out to the depth, then move it round to the next hole. So disengage the lever. There's 1. Looking at the holes on the side, 2, 3. There's number 4. Put the lever back in. Next turn, disengage. 1, 2, 3. It's a 4th hole there. And carry on until you form the hexagon on the end of the bar. Take this out the chuck. There's the hexagon we machined, and that just fits in there. So, simple way of making a chuck key. There's a better view of the indexing plate that's fixed. These 3 screws hold it in. and that has 24 positions. So if you can divide the number of flats or holes that you need into 24, you can use the indexing plate. Now, some of you are probably thinking, well, what's all this on the side here? Obviously, this is a handle to turn the dividing head, and 40 turns will give you one revolution. So if you can divide the number of divisions you want into 40, it just, say if it was 40 flats, you just turn it once. 20 flats, you turn it twice. So what if there's an odd number, you can't divide it? That's where these plates come in. You get three plates, the one that's fitted and another two here, and you can see they're just full of holes, and each hole or each circumference of holes has a different values. One plate, so say plate A, has 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20 holes. So that's circles of 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. Plate B has 21 to 33. Plate C has 37 to 49. So somewhere in those plates you'll find a way of dividing what you need. So if you look at the table, if you wanted to do 9 divisions, it's telling you to use an 18 hole plate, and you do 4 full turns and 8 holes on an 18 hole plate. This goes from one division all the way up to 370 divisions. That table is in the back of the book. So when you know which plate you need, to remove it, just take the handle off, undo the clamp that holds the dividers, and remove 3 screws and the plate will come off and you can change it to another plate. So this is where the dividers come in. You can select the plate and the number of holes. This will move up and down, so if I go on the top one, spring loading plunger should go into the hole. There we go. If the book said 4 turns and 8 holes, you'd bring the dividers up to the spring-loaded plunger and you count down your 8 divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Move the other side of the pointer up, let's put that in there. And once you've got the 8, you tighten the screw up, that locks it. So then when you've done that, you can push this whole thing round to there. 1, 2, 3, 4, which is there. Then move round to your 8th hole, which is there, and push that back round again for the next 8. Once you have your position, you can then lock the head with the spindle lock here. Leave this one out of the way, because don't need it. Machine whatever you need, and then carry on to your next 4 turns. This is just a quick way of counting the extra holes. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.